much it. And now I would like to request our dear Dr. Lallan Prasad to please come up on stage and share a few words with the batch.
Mr. Suresh Agrawal, members of the committee, and my dear students, it's a real pleasure to talk to you. I was just informed that I also to speak a few minutes. Let me first congratulate the organizers for having such a systematic and organized function, where you are deliberating on a very important aspect of Islamic life. If we talk about value creation, try to look into the countries in the world which have advanced and the countries which are rich in resources but they are poor. Take your own country. Why are we poor? Why have we been poor so far? Because we have been basically exporting raw materials. And you know, your raw materials which come out of the fields are from mines or minerals. They are valued at a very low cost in international markets. So the money that you get by exporting lot of richness to others, you get a very scanty amount. And people who import your products, which you have produced in a raw form, either it is cotton or it is iron, either it is aluminium or any other metal, you don't get value for that. People who purchase from you create value and sell it back to you. So, Koreans have been importing iron and ore from India and exporting grade one steel, very high quality steel to India. Now they have done the value addition. So what your mine owners or what your mines have got out of those raw materials is a very small proportion of the total amount which Koreans generate, or total benefit which Koreans generate out of the raw materials taken from you. Now this process of value creation has given West an edge over the entire Asian and African countries, which still continue reeling into poverty, and their own raw materials are being used to create richness for those countries. So this is at macro level that you can analyze and find out why we are poor